And welcome everybody here on Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Garen Draven. This is going to be our last deck today. We're going to try for another 5-0. Man, we have been just having all the luck today. We've been having some great games. We have been 10-0 on the day. Went on over from Platinum to Diamond. And we're going to try to keep that going with another Grand Plaza deck, this time with two very efficient champions for their size and mana cost. We got Draven, we got Garen. This should be a pretty good combination. Just basically, we're playing a lot of underrated cards. That's kind of what it comes down to. That we're going to be playing a lot of cards that, like, maybe our opponents don't necessarily expect, that maybe they're not necessarily ready for. You know, we'll have some spells like Whirling Death and Riposte and maybe survival skills and back-to-back and just a bunch of stuff that, like, while we're in combat, they may not really necessarily be ready for. And then we'll have good removal with single combat and concerted strike to go along with challenging everything with the Grand Plaza. Of course, as you already know, Grizzled Ranger and House Spider are both two cards that are amazing with the Grand Plaza, so we have that going on. And then we even have, like, Cythria giving Fearsome at the top end and Captain Farron finishing games with all the Decimates. We got a bunch of good stuff up there, too. And then Kato with the Overwhelm. So, like, lots of great things going on with this deck. So it'll be interesting to try out. So let's give it a try. We're going to go play our five games in Ranked. And we're going to try for another 5-0. We'll see if we can keep this going. Keep this win streak going. All right, we got Zoe, Aurelion Soul for our first one. This will be a tough matchup, a very good test. Love the Draven and the Garen, and we'll have survival skills protect Draven. This would be pretty nice to draw the Grand Plaza. Be able to play that on their turn three. Okay, so this is going poorly for me. They had good hand turn one Zoe, turn two Mountain Goat, especially with what I was, with like what I had going on. Yeah, this went very well for them, but the game's not over. We're very far behind, but we can catch up. I clicked pass, not a... Oh my gosh, I can't believe they played something. I can't believe it. I was trying to click, like, the okay, and I accidentally double-clicked, and it clicked the... clicked the pass. Saved. That was a lot of mana I would have just wasted. I can't believe they played that. Whoa, we got a donation! Thank you, Skew. Skew donated saying thanks for the content. That's very kind of you. Thank you so much, Skew. I can't tell you how much I appreciate that and put that to good use. Thank you so much, Skew. So this is a lot of mana here that I'm not going to be able to use. I'm very interested in just using Kato. Why did I say Kato? Sorry. Concerted Strike and just... Yeah, like, I think I'm just going to Concerted Strike kill the Zoe, I guess. Right? Like, yeah, I feel like I should just do that. This is just too much mana that I'm not going to use. My hand's kind of awkward. I would keep Draven and Garen again. It's just kind of unfortunate that we just drew Kato, Captain Farron, Kato, you know, like, just drew all these other 5+ mana cards. That's what happens sometimes. Yeah, I will not mind at all, Skew, if you want a donation deck. Devotion through battle. Now we're cooking. Oh, I was going to Whirling Death, but then I realized I won't have the 5 mana to be able to play. Like, I have to play, like, Kato or Garen this turn. So I'll just get one, because I was going to do that and then level up. I'll just do this to level up.
Time for the moneymakers.
Because I think we have to play Kato slash Garen this turn.
And I thought I was already perfect.
For justice, for Demacia. Who gets tossed?
So I want to play Kato over Cythria because I want to have the 3 mana for Whirling Death. Well, that makes no sense.
God axes need victims.
Why would you stun Kato instead of stunning Draven? Like, shouldn't you just stun the two champions? Because, like, Kato won't have anything to support. So, like, why would... Yeah, why would you not stun the other two? That didn't make much sense.
Come out and play.
We're about to have a lot of spinning axes, by the way. Lots of spinning axes over here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I can still draw a card. Obviously, I would have to get rid of all of these before playing like a Captain Farron. Obviously.
Power. Lead our charge.
Demacia, now and forever.
So I'm guessing they have even more Pale Cascades, how they attacked with the 3-2 into my Garen. I guess that means more Pale Cascades.
Nothing stands in our way.
Oh, I forgot about the Kato support, honestly. I was just thinking about, like, what's challenge here, and I completely forgot about the Kato support. Yeah, this was not... Draven was not the card to support, because Draven already had the Overwhelm. I should have supported one of these two. But I guess whichever one I supported, they would block the other... But yeah, that was not the correct thing to support. I think I should have supported the Cythria, I think, in general, and, like, have them try to block Garen. Yeah, I think that's what I think I should have done. So this was, yeah, like I should have supported Cythria. My bad.
Demacia will prevail.
Oh. Yes, I should have used that, an axe. I just liked how that was happening. I didn't want them to, like, play more cards. But yeah, I guess I... Because, let's see. Because this is... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Should have used an axe. But that would give them priority again. They'd probably just pass back to me. Probably.
Time for the moneymakers.
Enough! I'll end this!
You'd have axed Spider and another axe. So you would have... Okay, so you would have... You would have gone out for that 2 damage on them. I wish that this judgment, this Garen was just like the judgment. That'd be nice. I can probably pass.
Now they see who I truly am.
I did want to leave open the possibility of them passing, and I wasted all 9 of that mana. Isn't too likely with them having the challengers, but was still likely, or still a possibility. Of course, I gotta use the sharp sight to block Zoe, so they get to have very good attacks on my other stuff that I was gonna save. So I can discard 2 decimates to kill this blocker. Right, like I discard, you know, because it's three here, so I can discard House Spider, decimate.
Die of boredom?
That's probably not worth it. Oh, I should have just discarded 1 spinning axe though, because I am out of, so I should just put this down to 4-2. Never mind. We'll just do this. I was going to say that I'm out of room with 10 cards in hand, but actually if I just cast the House Spider, I still have like 10 mana to cast 2 decimates. Like 10 mana is still a good amount of mana for us to have with all this other stuff. Let's do you.
I give you muscles.
And now I can have double decimates and use all these spinning axes to do extra amounts of damage. Alright, so that puts them down to 7, and they're at just 2 mana, and only 3 cards. Hush. Why'd I just do that? I should've just... I was gonna say, like, if they just played Hush right here, then that just did no overwhelm damage, and I just wasted all of this. Wow. That was very bad into Hush. Yeah, I went all in Farron. And then if they had a Hush... Wow. Everything's going good for us, though, today. So it works out. Want to know. That was not a recommended strategy, what I just pulled off, though. I would not recommend doing that same thing. Answer Soggy's question, the important question. What are the OP emotes? What do y'all think? What do y'all think are the OP emotes? Leona, Aurelion Soul. Let's mulligan our top end. Honestly, I should probably mulligan Fleet Feather Tracker here, too. I should probably keep Garen. I should probably mulligan the rest and keep Garen. Alright, people would say Lulu is an answer. Gucci says Aurelion Soul. Edgar likes the Ezreal.
Raise your weapon, Sunwind.
Juicy seems to be meta, so I'm trying to avoid that one, but Aurelion Soul seems like a sleeper OP. Yeah, I love the Aurelion Soul one. I've always loved the Teemo one and the Elise one. Like the Elise, like kind of laughing, it's not too, you know, it's not too like cruel. I love this one. That one's good. His little smirk. That one's good. I think I should save that one. Oh yeah, see, opponent knows what's going on. That's a good one. Yeah, the Vladimir Cheers is a yep, that's certainly good. Believe or burn.
Proud warriors of the sun's true light. No mercy for heretics. The strength of the sun and my faith are one.
Who gets tossed?
Forge ahead!
Watch and learn.
Warning, take you.
What? Block the overwhelm? There you go. I think riposte on Kato and Draven is probably more valuable than saving that thing. Even though saving that Badger Bear dealt 9 damage to them, I think I'd rather be able to try to save these things.
Slow down, will you?
If I don't play the Grizzled Ranger, I could play both riposte and Concerted Strike, and so maybe that's what I was supposed to do. Have both of those available. Gosh, that card is broken.
Behold the divine power of the sun.
Okay, so yeah, I guess I should have had both available. Most likely. We both have 3 cards in hand. Really wish I had a Grand Plaza. You know, we're playing 3 Grand Plazas also. That was something about the Shyvana Dragons deck that we just got done playing, as we drew Grand Plaza like every single game. It sure would be a good draw right now.
Her light is our sword, her warmth our armor.
Another lifesteal thing. Yeah, we only had 2 plazas in the Shyvana deck. And we had it every single game. This one we have 3 Shyvanas.
Go time. Up top.
Fall, heretic.
Good news. The good news is we just did draw back-to-back house spiders, where we probably can't draw any more house spiders. So hopefully we don't. Hopefully we draw, you know, Captain Farron. You know, like, draw, like, our good cards, not, like, the super cheap anti-aggro cards right now. Okay, well, it's a champion. Can't be too mad at that. Not Captain Farron, but... still a champion.
For justice! For Demacia!
For Demacia. And that's it. They'll pack it up. Pack your bags. We 2-0. Oh no, more Zoe with Lee Sin. This is a scary deck. Really, just some scary champions. Concerted Strike, awesome against Lee Sin. Tracker, good against Zoe. I guess I'll keep one Concerted Strike. I kind of want to keep both Concerted Strike, to be honest. Kind of wanted to keep both.
The spirit gives to those who listen.
What? Eye of the Dragon. Who plays that card?
It is time.
A 1-3? I just have 2/1s. Can't play a 1-3. That's cheating. No, I'm not gonna riposte there.
Alright, let's mess some folks up.
I am prepared.
Ah, quit your yapping. Ah, shut up.
I guess I'm not gonna Lent. I was gonna say I'm not gonna let Hush, or sorry, Pale Cascade. I'm not gonna let Pale Cascade just like make me use like these other cards. Okay. So Grizzled Ranger still traded for 2 cards, but they got a gem in the process. I think that's worth it. I know I could have tried like single combat save, but I think it's better to wait. I'm gonna wait. I think single combat with Garen sounds much better.
We fight for those who cannot.
No, we fight for Demacia.
Force is meaningless without skill.
A pleasure to see you, Master.
So let's say I go single combat Lee Sin with Garen and they go Pill Cascade. Then I challenge and we kill Lee Sin with the 2-1. So is that worth it? Is that worth, they get to draw an additional card. So they'll have 6 cards in hand. I'll have 4 cards in hand. They'll have Eye of the Dragon and I'll have a 2-1. I think that's probably worth it too, also because like how important Lee Sin is to their deck. Just how vital Lee Sin is. I guess this is worth it. Where, you know, like we have Captain Farron in our hands. That's Lee Sin's kind of their only way to kill me quickly. Yeah, they've had a great hand, for sure.
It is me!
If I play the Draven, I can hold up the riposte. But I'm gonna go with the Kato to not waste as much mana, assuming I don't cast riposte.
With my spirit, not my fist.
Me something cool.
much is gained when you return malevolence?
I have the best job.
Do you think Zoe should cost one regular mana and one spell mana to play? I don't think you can really... I don't know if that's possible. I do wish, speaking of spell mana, I wish I had one more spell mana. I wish I could have Riposte and Whirling Death. I have two pieces of interaction. What are they grabbing? Single combat? Have I played anything besides single combat? I guess we'll find out. Yep, it's single combat. Yeah, I think it's just Riposte. I could, you know, I could Whirling Death this thing with like the go Draven Whirling Death. Yeah, we're definitely killing Zoe. I just have two different ways to do it. I could Riposte or Draven Whirling Death this thing. I think I'm gonna do Whirling Death. I think I'll do that. We get an extra spinning axe. You're gonna need that. I'm not discarding any of these to level up Draven. But it's basically which one's, you know, the question is which one's going to be more valuable in the, you know, later on. With me already having a Concerted Strike, I think Concerted Strike and Whirling Death kind of overlap. And so we'll keep the Riposte. Breathe in, breathe out. That's not the easiest decision to make.
Force is meaningless. Without skill.
A pleasure to see you, Master.
I mean, do I just Concerted Strike that now, or... Yeah, I mean, now, true. I wish I would have used Riposte last turn now and then had Whirling Death and Concerted Strike both. Yeah, that's true, I guess. Yeah, I guess I should have really thought about that of, like, what if they slam... If they slam Lee Sin next turn, which one do I want? Yeah, so Bastion and Deny are both cards they play.
My lad, prepare yourself.
So if they play a spell, I should be able to respond afterwards. I can Spinning Axe, pump up the Kato. Like, if they would play, like, a Pale Cascade, I'd be able to pump up the Kato. Because Concerted Strike should work against Pale Cascade and Barrier and everything anyway. All right, so yeah, two Lee Sin down, one Zoe down, one Mountain Goat down, probably another Mountain Goat down here in just a second.
Ready yourself.
Yeah, as long as they don't have like the third Lee Sin. I don't envision them winning this as long as they don't have the third Lee Sin. I know, I could level up Draven if I give it both Spinning Axes, but I also don't want to make it too good for them to, you know, then use Concussive Palm on my Draven. So I spread the wealth out a little bit. Just a little bit. Spread the wealth out just a little bit.
Speak, stars. Speak, I say!
I wanted to spread it out. So like the Farron did 6 damage to them, the Draven did 7. Instead of it being 8 damage with Draven and 5 with Farron. Which, to be fair, maybe that's not a big enough difference to matter and I should have just gone with it, tried to level up Draven. I think that either way we should be just fine. I am not scared of this Sparkle Fly in the slightest.
Well, that still keeps them at 7. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Zenith Blade. Boo, Zenith Blade. I forgot. Overwhelm Zenith Blade. That's a draw step right there. Good thing I waited on House Spider. Put the lifesteal stuff over there. And that'll be it. G to the G, we are 3-0.
All me. And maybe those other guys. Whatever.
I'm pretty sure Overwhelm was in the base game. Like, whenever I started the game in February, which, you know, that was still, like, the open... Like, that was in the open beta. That wasn't in the closed beta. But whenever I started it, then Overwhelm was in the game. Like, that was a big part of the game. So, like, this kind of matchup, I don't love Fleet Feather Tracker as much. It's kind of easy for them to kill a Fleet Feather Tracker. And Cythria is kind of expensive. So, you know what? I'm going to keep Fleet Feather Tracker, though. Because it's still just a one-mana card. Like, it's so efficient. And even if they use, like, whatever spell to kill it, like, at worst, it, like, trades on mana. See, I love that. I love that trade, honestly. Like, Thermogenic Beam's a really good card. I love that trade. As we all...
The party has arrived.
Yeah, lots of Garens, lots of Dravens, lots of champions. They are scared of Sharp Sight, which is why they didn't do anything there.
Alright,
this is a little... A little sad that since I spent that one mana earlier, I don't have the one mana for Whirling Death, but also they don't have a Thermogenic Beam in hand, so that's the good, non-sad part of that. Yeah, we had full house with our champions, five of our six champions. So you recommend Darius to just give you one... Daria should give you a decimate on your attack token. Whenever you gain the attack token, you gain a decimate.
God axes need victims.
That would be pretty good. That would be pretty good.
If you could back it up.
But now they're not scared of... Hmm. They were scared before, but not now. Yeah, Darius should probably just be a beat stick. That was the question. Should Darius be just be a beat stick? I'd say the answer is yes, probably should be.
Didn't think your big brother would be so big.
Don't even think about it.
Charge!
Draven out?
So ordinary.
Well, Worst case scenario for me is Ravenous Flock. Which is, like, you kind of expect with that block. But that's still a 2-for-1. Like, kind of my worst case scenarios are 2-for-1s. Kind of. Now, this Ezreal. Ezreal's gonna be a problem if we can't draw Sharp Sight, or Single Combat, or Concerted Strike, or Grand Plaza. If we don't draw any of those cards, this Ezreal will be a problem.
Didn't think your big brother would be so big.
Don't even think about it.
Firing! Check me out!
Or Flea Feather Tracker. I guess Flea Feather. Flea Feather Tracker would help. Wouldn't be as. It'd be better than not drawing that. So 29 cards, so like what, half the deck? Flea Feather Tracker, Grand Plaza, Single Combat, Concerted Strike, Sharp Sight. Alright, there's the Sharp Sight.
Time for the main event.
Didn't think her big brother would be so big.
Don't even think about it.
Yeah, our hand was all champions.
Witness perfection. Bags.
Which has its ups and downs.
Inferior design.
Now we're cooking.
Alright, so I'm at 13.
Can you improve perfection?
I really thought about discarding like Cythria to make it to 4. I didn't want it to be that obvious though.
Out of my way.
So Single Combat's perfect. So like our last two draws were perfect. Sharp Sight, Single Combat, those are the cards that we needed. And this game should be over, and there should be a 4-0. But we'll see. It's not over yet, but I am, you know, very confident that I'm going to win this game. Maybe I shouldn't be so confident. Brash Gambler? Okay, now we're talking.
Sounds dangerous. I'm in.
Brash Gambler is pretty nice.
Something up my sleeve.
This is gonna hurt for you. Time for the money makers.
Yeah, they don't have any Nexus healing, so yeah, two Decimates should be able to finish the job.
The world's a big place. Let's see all of it.
Cool. No Ravenous Flock, that's good.
No way.
That's also good that, you know, like I needed, you know, I wanted Ezreal out of here so they don't get all of like the free damage from an Ezreal. And the double decimate should just finish them now, because I don't think they can do 11 damage to me, you know, with just these cards responding to these decimates now. you know, like with an Ezreal in play, maybe they have, you know, a good amount of like Mystic Shots and Get Excited or something like that. Aftershock for like one of them and Mystic Shots. But without an Ezreal, feel pretty good about this. Only 6 mana. There we go. GG's. All right. 4-0.
Damn, I'm good.
We'll make that 14-0. Okay, this is going to be tougher. I would rather play against the Draven Ezreal. I think that our deck matches up pretty well against the Draven Ezreal. Our things are pretty difficult to kill. The Draven Jinx is, you know, discard aggro, which is much, much more aggressive. Our things don't line up nearly as well. All right, I'm going to keep the Garen. And let's give this a try. This
the party has a rat.
Isn't the best of draws for me so far. With it, you know, a second Garen and a survival skills. I definitely wish I would have mulliganed the first Garen. Okay, I love that. Because I have a slow hand. So the more they want to pass, the better for me. I'm kind of scared of Jury Rig.
Hey, kiddo. Dig your get up.
Man. This is just such a bad mulligan. All these cards. Like, I can't play any of these cards.
Rules are made to be broken. Like buildings. Or people.
You should try blinking sometime.
This was such a bad mulligan. Yeah, that's why I did not attack the previous turn, was the Jury Rig.
Let's boogie.
This is awesome.
Who are my two favorite champions? Wait, they had survival skills also? Really, Draven? I couldn't have had you earlier.
My heart and soul for Demacia.
My blurg and blue for Bablavia.
That is one of my favorite lines. Jinx.
I stand
taunting Garen like that.
With this Joker.
Man, what a way to finish this. Having a really bad hand where we had like nothing to do.
Time for the money makers.
We had nothing to do turn 2, 3, 4. I kept Fleet Feather Tracker and Garen, and we didn't draw anything for the between turns against the aggro deck. Anyway, the question was, what are my two favorite champions? I would probably say Teemo and Katarina. Those are both very fun to play champions.
Watch and learn.
Yeah, it's not over yet.
Hold fast.
So yes, I did open myself up to a burn spell of killing me, but if they had the burns, if I try the two single combats and they have the burn spell, they kill me anyway.
We fight for those who cannot.
Sorry, did you say something? Let's boogie. Now we're cooking.
Thank you. Well. That's too bad. Didn't finish out the perfect day. Just had such a bad mulligan against Discard Burn. This deck's awesome. You know, like this Discard Burn deck. Gohard has been holding this deck back. And they had a great hand. You know, like, they really did. They had a great hand. My hand was terrible. And we lost. So, ended up losing our 15th game of the day.
This is what losing feels like.
GG.
Sucks.
Like, yeah, we can take turn two off. That's okay with our deck with all the, with like, you know, different two mana spells and everything. Where's our deck? You know, like we have like our single combat, our sharp side. It's okay to take turn two off, but then take turn three off and take turn four off. Like that was just the, you know, the nail in the coffin, right? Like I guess I shouldn't have kept Garen, but I kept Garen and Flea Feather Tracker, and then just we had Garen. We had a second Garen, survival skills, single combat, which, you know, I only had Flea Feather Tracker, so single combat doesn't really help that much at that point. And then Captain Farron. Unfortunately, I just didn't have anything to do forever. We needed, you know, like these cards here in the middle, right? Like we needed, besides single combat, besides that one, we needed, you know, Bright Steel Protector, House Spider, Sharpside, Draven, Grand Plaza, Whirling Death, Grizzled Ranger. All right, but there we go. So that's Garen Draven. Impressive deck still. You know, like that was just an outlier that last game for how we drew. That isn't something that would happen that often, but it's still an impressive deck. You know, just again, like I said at the very beginning, whenever we started this deck, these are a lot of cards that are really underrated and a lot of cards that maybe our opponent wouldn't necessarily be expecting. But it is a deck that is, you know, very effective. Like, like that last game we played against the Draven Jinx deck. Whoa! Mafia Plot, thank you so much for the donation, for the real good, for the good run. Real nice. Thank you so much. And we played against the Draven Jinx that last game. That's what I was saying. And that's going to be a tougher matchup. The Draven Ezreal's super good matchup, I think. Basically, I think a lot of matchups are pretty good for this deck, honestly. Except for, like, the very... Like, that's... I feel like that's how, like, this deck loses against the very, very fast deck where your hand is really bad to start with. Right? But besides that, I think these cards are good and just really underrated. I think this is a very good deck. Yeah, I'd be confident in running this back and doing really well again with it. Because think about, like, our strongest card is probably the Grand Plaza, right? Like, this obviously is, like, a Grand Plaza deck. Grand Plaza is really strong. And think of how little we had the Grand Plaza. I think we only had it maybe one game towards the beginning. We had, like, one game where we played it at the very end and, you know, like, instantly won when we played the Grand Plaza, but we were going to probably win that one anyway. Puppy, come here. Oh, what did you think of this deck, Puppy? Was this deck pretty good? Puppy's just like, oh, it's late. I want some food. maybe just that one game on the end. I was thinking that, like, one of our first games, maybe we had an early Plaza, but maybe not. Maybe we just didn't even have Plaza ever. I think, like, maybe our very first game, I think we had an early Plaza, I think. But maybe not. Yeah, maybe we just never even really had Grand Plaza, which obviously would, you know, make this deck even better. So that's what I'm saying is that's a testament to this deck. That we ended up going 4-1 and we didn't have early plazas except for maybe one game. And yeah, people in chat are saying they don't really remember having it. So maybe zero, you know, zero or one at most. But besides that, it went pretty good. I'm very skeptical of survival skills, that it's necessary. Very skeptical of this card, but we didn't really try it out too much. You know, I had it like that last game, but you know, that's another card that you can't really play early. And doesn't really do very much unless you have Draven, but we'll see. But yeah, I like the deck. So yeah, you say it's for, yeah, against like Shen Fiora, you trade, it's like, you know, shuts down. You like just trade a spinning axe with your survival skills for a riposte. I mean, you can think of it like that, but you're still trading survival skills for a riposte. You're like, you're still trading one for one. They're just spending four mana and you're spending zero.
But then it also hurts your unit. All right, anyway, those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there. Puppy would be very appreciative, right, Puppy? Yeah, Puppy would really appreciate it if you hit that like button and leave those comments. Those comments really help the channel. So let me know what you think of the deck. Let me know if you liked the Garen Draven deck. It did great. 4-1s are difficult to have in ranked. Like, that's, you know, that's not easy to do. Our deck did it. Plus, we did it without, like, our number one card, you know, basically ever making a difference. So that's really impressive. So yeah, leave those comments and all that kind of stuff. But I really appreciate you for watching. Thank you so much. I can't say that enough. Thanks for watching. And I will see you for the next video.